Yo, what up? Welcome to the stream. We're gonna play more Dragon Quest XI. Alright, so I might be in a slightly different location than where I started from. I'm over in Champ Savage right now. The reason I was over there is because I was trying to get Seeds of Life. Yeah. Right, we should go fight the witch now. Right. Yeah, who disguised herself as the queen. Yeah, the queen of the... Yeah, she's disguised herself as the queen and led us to defeat a beast that unsealed her magic. You know, a bit like Ganondorf. A bit like when we took out the Master Sword in Wind Waker, yeah? And it unsealed Ganondorf's power, man. Although Ganondorf was pretty powerful back in that game anyway, with that seal on him, man. He like blew up an entire island, man. Damn, look at these dudes. Now, I'm gonna try to show you the Seed of Life. Basically, you get the Seed of Life from these guys. Yeah, if we don't get the Seed of Life from the other... If we don't get the other items from the other dudes... I'll show you what I mean. I'll show you what I... How I game up with this in a moment. You're probably wondering how I'm getting Seeds of Life reliably, man. Well, it's simple. I actually got some more bunny tails. And I got 8 of them. Oh good, they called in a lot of backup. That'll make getting Seeds of Life a lot easier, man. It's like a 1 in 16 chance... It's like a 16 out of 100 per enemy. So it's actually good that they're calling in backup. Damn, these corpse corporals are pretty powerful. Damn, Eric's cursed. Paralyzed, of course. Yeah, lots of enemies late game and post game have paralyzing breath. Alright, did we get the item? No, but we got a bronze lance. Damn. Alright, so I promised I was gonna show you what I was gonna do, what I was doing, right? Alright, so let's go to equipment. Basically, we got bunny tails on all 4 main party members. The Skrull Go uniform also helps too, man. Oh, good. We might have a chance at getting them this time. Yeah, it's not always 100% like you get with Hallelujah, though. But it might take a couple battles to get it. The corpse corporals are the ones that drop it, though. Damn, not that time, huh? Well, it just so happens they're pretty numerous in this region. Frick a lot of other enemies. But that's okay. This enemy here has a chance of getting... You have a chance of getting a Seed of Deafness. Which will be good for Eric. Because Deafness, apparently, I looked it up, it affects your steal rate. Which means you'll have a better chance of stealing from enemies. Not that we're gonna be needing that anymore. Although we might actually need it still. Good call for backup. That's actually what I want you to do. Damn, I wish these zombies didn't have so much health, man. Yeah, but later they're gonna get, like, vicious and then malicious, man. And then they'll be even stronger. You're probably wondering what I mean. Well, that's in the Act 2, and then there's Act 3. Yeah, and Act 2 is where they start getting red-eyed because of the Dark Lord and everything. And then they become even stronger with that. But in freaking post-game, they get even crazier, man. Oh, they dropped it. Oh, they dropped the Seed of Life and they dropped in a grabby bandage. Yep, we got one. Amazon, we got one. And there's also Seeds of Strength. Right, we should probably go fight the witch. Right. I'll just throw the seeds off stream, man. So basically what I plan to do off stream is basically grind for hours on seeds, man. Yeah, I want them Seeds of Life and Seeds of Strength, man. Those are probably the two seeds you want, man. Right, we should probably equip everybody properly. Alright. Put on your spangle dress again. Let's see, the witch uses a lot of ice magic. Trust me, she has freeze breath for days, man. I'm not really sure. I remember her having something. I remember that ice witch having something pretty annoying. Can't remember for the life of me what it is. Oh well, I'm sure we'll be able to beat her pretty easily. We're actually really strong at this point in the game. Echoing might... We're actually pretty strong at this point in the game, man. We might be okay for a while. Until we lose to a plot armor boss or something. Yeah, there's a plot armor boss. It's at the end of the first act. Yeah, of course, being the Dark Lord. Well, you don't fight the... Well, it's not the Dark Lord you fight, it's frickin' Jasper, man. You remember that guy, that bastard. Wait, why am I equipping you with these things? You're not in the party. You're not in the party. You're not in the party. Right, we gotta get it for Silvando. Yes, I want to disable losing turns, which is what Angel's Handles are really good for. Which is really gonna save us against frickin' Oogie Boogie Man. Neesum told they work for him, but I'm not sure about that. I don't know just yet, but seems to stop actions that cause you to lose turns. Alright, let's fight her. I can do this, she's not that hard. Yeah, she's pretty tough, too. Ice Witch is pretty tough, but... Listen, Doran Gray was pretty tough, too. And I beat her pretty easily, too. So who knows, this might be just as easy, man. And we're like level 40... I think we're close to level 50, so we should be able to be fine at this point. I mean, we were like level 40 for frickin' Doran Gray, man. Hello, Queen. It's interesting that you sent us on a mission to destroy that magic beast. You remember that, right? Oh, yes. It turns out that magic beast is a seal on the witch's power. Do you know anything about that? Let's find out.
Oh, there you all are.
Yeah, Veronica's getting annoyed. Uh-oh.
What?
Wait, that wound.
I knew it! That's the burn you got when I hit you with my fireball! You're not the queen at all! You're the witch!
Wait, so getting hit with fireballs causes real injuries, but when we beat her, she's gonna be perfectly fine. Later, right?
Oh, dearie.
Yes, watch me throw my glasses and be really cool. And do a magical girl transformation in front of you. Hello there. Yeah, we met before. I believe we... Oh damn, she's got Super Saiyan levels of evil.
Thank you so much
much for taking care of that pesky power plunderer for me. Now I'm bursting with energy again, just like old times.
Let's see. According to power scaling, she should be already a city buster, because she froze the entire city. And this power scaling is actually very accurate. Trust me, I've seen it on First's Battles Wiki, but you know it's accurate. Now she's gone Super Saiyan, so she's probably at a Planet Buster level right now. Which means when we beat her, we're beyond Planet Buster level. Yes, that's how it works, guys.
And I believe we have some unfinished business. The heroic...
I know the spell to seal her away again.
It's time to fight. I know she has something really annoying up her sleeve.
Let's go!
Let's poison her. Yes, she's toxic. That's good. Alright, let's see. We should go Hard Claw. We gotta take her out quickly. There we go. That's the stuff. Let's do Unbridled Blade, man. Frick! Wait, I know what to do. Let's go with this. Here you go, Eric. You can be even more of a Chad now. Wait, what? Damn, she almost did that freeze move to me. Damn, she's got like two turns, huh? Still might health, huh? Not for much longer.
Time to duck and dive!
We might take her out before we do the combo. Right, let's accelerate. Let's speed everybody up. Only a normal attack, huh? Uh-oh, a breath attack. That hurt. Alright, Eric. Time to be really cool and do the really cool thing that's gonna wreck this- that's gonna wreck her. Watch this shit, man. Alright, this is the move that hits when toxified, right? Let's do it. Damn, look at that damage, dude! Holy crap, man! Damn, that's a lot of damage. She's gonna need some flex tape to fix all that, man. Oh yes, Jade leveled up. Cool. Okay, do we have enough skill points to do anything with Jade? And we can't get that, but... can do stuff on her earlier tree. I kind of want more pep chance. I could get her more charm. I'll save the skill point. Alright, we got Sylvando's stuff to unlock. Let's unlock Sylvando's dual wielding. Yes, please. Yeah, we gotta get that next. Damn, Eric is a Chad, man. His hair is permanently Super Saiyan Blue, man. That's how you know Eric is actually a Super Saiyan God, man.
Now, Snorri, use the ceiling.
Do it, man.
Okay. Pella.
No. Stop it. Please, anything but that.
Lady, you froze an entire city.
Helter skelter ba- I wonder how-
Snorri! What kind of scholar are you? Pull yourself together!
Veronica, don't get salty, man.
Yes, I- Hexbiali-
Hexbialidocious?
Oh,
Okay, goodbye. You're sealed up in the book now.
No, please forgive me. I'll do anything. I'll change my ways, I promise.
No. Ed, I don't believe you. Ed, don't believe her. Hey, look, all the ice is going away. Now it's no longer frozen.
Look, the ice, it's melting.
Now it's not frozen anymore. Cool. Spring has come. Cool. There we go. Hey, this looks a lot like the Russian cathedral. Oh, hey, are you the real queen?
What? Where am
I? You're mad.
Yeah, she was sealed inside the book.
Oh, yes. I remember now.
Thank goodness for a moment.
Ah, so she trapped her and then possessed her.
Your Majesty, we've been searching for you everywhere.
You need the blue orb, don't you? I heard you talking about it from inside the book. Come and see me at the castle. I will gladly give it to
you. Oh, you heard that, okay. Sure, we'll get the final orb.
As for the grimoire, Snorri.
Hold on a minute, Your Majesty. I don't think you understand.
Okay, thank you for the witch's grimoire. I know that Sir Jasper was the one that released her. Yeah, how do we know that? Because the witch was definitely talking about that locket that Sir Hendrick had. The only other and Sir Hendrick seemed to know who that was. You knew it was Jasper, man. Means Jasper was up to no good, man. Sure, I'll take a tour of this place. I'll take a tour around town. You've got stuff to pilfer, find. Yeah, we need it for our journey, you see, for, being a good chosen one, man. Yeah. We're the chosen one. We can take people's stuff if we want. That's not what being a chosen one is about, Esther. Oh, hey, a tour guide. But we can look around and see all the sights ourselves, man. It would be nice to have some information about what to do. Hey, wasn't there a treasure chest I was supposed to get? Oops, I'm sorry about your snowman. I accidentally knocked it over. It feels bad, man. I really like snowmen. Hey, what's this right here? Come on, something useful. Mini metal, cool. Wait, so how many mini metals does that make, man? Let's see, we have 36 of them. Oh, we can claim another prize, cool. Cool, we have 40. That means we now have enough to get something cool. Hey there, you're a little suspicious. Wait. Puff Puff, I mean, okay. I guess we have to meet her there, yes. let's look around this inn. See, there's a couple doors here. As you can plainly see. Hey there, you look a little like the Abominable Snowman. I think it might be the same character bottle. Ooh, platinum stuff. Now we can make some platinum claws, too. Well, I might be interested in making platinum claws. Are they better for Jade than what she's got right now? Hey, Taco. I can see you don't have a password. But you are going to become relevant later in the post-game. Which is the third act of the game. Of course, the third act of the game is where the game starts getting really hard, man. And where you're really going to have to test your skills, man. Yeah, lots of bosses have freaking paralysis breath in that in post-game, man. Yeah, like the zombie did, man. Oh, right, I'm sorry. It's not a zombie, it's a corpse corporal. And how did it even get that rank, dude? Royal Rupee. That seems like it's a rare item. Speaking of rare items, we should probably equip our bunny tails again. Yes. Now, you're probably wondering what the bunny tails actually do. Now let's see. Wide view details. You see, there's a slight chance that dropping items will be slightly increased. Which means, yes, they will make getting rare drops a lot easier. Now the schoolgirl uniform also has that same effect. See? There it is, right there. Wait a minute. I did not want to equip that vest. Although the vest is pretty good. Nice to get that little bonus. Alright, Tavondo, you need some bunny tails too. Heck, maybe if we reforge these, they'll have a better chance of giving us some good items. I don't know if that's really true or not. Alright, Veronica, you can equip some stuff. Equip these, please, and, yeah, equip that. I really like your king outfit. You know, as much as the piglet is pretty cute, I think I want her to be the Metal Maniac. I think it looks a little bit better on her. Of course, dressing Veronica up in silly clothing is pretty cool. I like that you can get the option to do that if you want. Oh, that book was frozen and now it's illegible. You can't read it. Now, that's unfortunate. Sadly, the elements are not very kind to books, man. Books are fine for people to keep in their houses but yeah, the elements are not kind to them. Shame, I like books. Books are fun. Books are as fun as video games, man. So are TV shows, so are board games. There was lots of things, man. Like music, dancing, critical stuff. Even art, too, and making stories, man. So anyway, I was actually thinking about a couple ideas, man. Like, what if in... Let's see, one villain I have in mind is an angry tsundere that was rejected from the... that wanted to join the hero's party, but she was kind of physically abusive towards the main protagonist, so the main protagonist was like, no, I'm not gonna allow you to join the party, man. She tried to force herself onto it, but it ended up in a fight, man. And what happened from there was that... Well... She ended up becoming a rival character that had to be fought 6 times, and every time she was fought, she would slowly turn herself into more of a death machine and get more and more cyborg, and get more and more, and turn more and more into a cyborg. Yes. Yeah, she also tried to join the evil Chosen One's party. Yeah, but that didn't turn out well for obvious reasons, and she was eventually kicked off of that for being too extreme even for him, man. You kind of blame the main protagonist for kind of getting her kicked out, man. Kind of blame the main protagonist for everything, man. Hey, look, it's a zombie Bane. Ooh, and there's a Razor Wing. I wonder if that's as good as... It's a Razor Wing. Yeah, but my Yeah, that's a sword. That's a broadsword, but my Platinum Power Sword is a little bit better than that. Actually, a lot better than that. There's boomerangs for Eric. Yeah, we don't need those wands. The wands are already better than that, man. I've already got better whips than that. Got better claws than that. Man, I can see why Draconian Quest has no shops as an option. Now that actually works. Because it turns out forging stuff is actually really broken in this game, man. Actually much better than the stuff you get at the shops, man. Of course, one of the other Draconian Quest stuff is no armor, man. And I'm not quite sure how that works. But the thing I would dread the most would probably be doing... Well, let's see, what was it? Frickin' Super Shy Pox, man. I don't know if I'd be able to handle that, man. That sounds like a bunch of nonsense, dude. Magical Skirt, I don't need that. Hey, we finally found something that's... Wait a minute, I forgot I have the schoolgirl uniform equipped on her. Is the new armor better than the spangled dress? Where is it? No, it's actually worse than it. I guess we don't need it. Hairy vest? We don't need a hairy vest. No. I guess we'll take a magic hat. For Rab. Wait. I wanted it for Veronica. Not even that much better, man. It's just 1 point of defense. Hey, did I go up here yet? Alright, I've already been up here. Right, so there's an evil Chosen One in the lore, man. Basically, the evil Chosen One was basically someone... Basically, this dude who was basically with all the bronze and looks and everything. And came from a rich, wealthy family. And basically, basically, they pulled a legendary stone that was part of a ritual to choose a chosen one out of a stone, so they were seen as a chosen one. However, they were actually really cruel and arrogant underneath all that. And actually not very good people. It was not actually a very good person, man. And turns out that what they're doing actually causes problems for the world, man. Yeah, it turns out exterminating political rivals of the kingdom and stuff actually leads to bad things happening, man. Yeah, that's basically what Chosen Ones are just meant for, to eliminate political rivals. Yeah, the ritual was a tradition passed down by thousands of years that was supposed to pick the Chosen One properly and truly. But it turns out it was all nonsense. I'm also considering possibly making another villain, making this villain possibly an Esekai, a villainous Esekai protagonist. You know, like they were chosen from another world, man, because the people of the world believed that they would be able to summon a champion from another world to be their representative and carry out what they wanted for them. But nope. Turns out they're kind of a bad guy. That could be an interesting plot point, I guess. And a real hero is just like, dude, we're hiring an unqualified freaking... Real hero's like, no, we're relying on an unqualified dude that doesn't have any training, that's just a high schooler? No, we can't do that.
What was that, Serena?
Yeah, it's the witch.
I thought so, but...
No, it's the witch's book. It could be an interesting plot point, I guess. I know how popular freaking Esekai stuff is. It seems like there's all sorts of weird ones now. I mean, there's this one weird Esekai where a dude is reincarnated as a hot spring. And then there's another one where a dude is reincarnated as a spider. And then there's another Esekai where this dude is turned into a succubus and they have to feed on a magic cow to survive, man. Yeah. Or otherwise they would starve, man. Yeah, Esekais are getting weirder and weirder, man. Oh yeah, there's also an Esekai where somebody gets turned into a vending machine, man. A freaking magic vending machine. Yeah, and they ended up getting carried around by a cute girl. Because of course they did. Oh, thank you for the password, little purple dude. Hey, we got a couple of new knives. But I haven't actually equipped those. No. Ah, here we are. The falcon knife is a little weaker than what I got, but it hits twice. But I do want this nobleman's knife. That's a little bit better than what I got. Falcon knife earring is a little weaker than what I got. Let me crunch some numbers real quick. It's at 177. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It's 9 points weaker though. But it hits twice. Yeah, that'll. If I hit twice at a little bit lower attack power, it should do actually even more damage. Yes, I think that could work. Oh, so what's this? This is an elevator. It's gonna take us down into the dungeon. Maybe we can put the book down here. Hey there, you look like the same model as the Heliodorian Knights. Oh look, there's breakable barrels here. I don't even know what I picked up, man, but I assume it's some sort of medicine. I cannot access these without the ultimate key. And you don't get the ultimate key until you get post-game, man. Hi there, tackle dude. Savvy Sapphire, okay. I'm not really sure what the gemstones even do. Or what they're for. I know I want them, though. Ooh, Seed of Sorcery. That's basically for anyone who's a spellcaster. Mostly Veronica. Mostly Veronica and Serena. Okay, I don't know where this way leads. This way could lead somewhere interesting. Am I allowed to go in here? No, that's a prison. We don't want to be there. And look at this prison, it's like all golden stuff and well decorated. Damn. I wish the king would have put us in a place like that, man. Damn, who are they keeping inside that prison there? Alright, let's go. Also, Seeds of Strength will drop off of brownies and trolls. There's actually an entire island full of those enemies. They can get a lot of those.
Oh, yeah? What's
the dude, it's obvious it's not you. It's obviously not one of you two. Is she trying to pretend to be the queen again? Wait a minute. That's not the real queen there, is it? Frick, of course. Yo, queen, can we have the orb now?
Ah, excellent.
Stop. The book. Okay, what?
I will ask one question to... Here is the question. What is the true treasure of Sniffelheim?
That's easy.
Nope.
Now then.
The true treasure of Sniffelheim is its people.
Hey, the queen is in the book. Yep, that's her.
Precisely.
No! She's a... Oh, yeah?
Hit her with a fireball. Fireball her again. Damn, she's still got that burn mark. Frick.
Fine. You...
Yes, watch me be cool. Finally, the real queen shows up.
Oh, I wait all that time to get my powers back, and you make me waste every last drop on escaping that wretched book again. My magic is spent. My life is yours.
Men?
No, don't. Do it, do it, do it, do it. Take her to the dungeon.
Wait.
Really? Dude, come on.
Your Majesty.
What's this about? You know, be reasonable. Tell us what's going on here. Why are you doing this?
Queen Frisabel, please, step on.
Everyone, listen to me. But we spoke from time to time when she held me captive. Hers is not a bad heart.
No. I disagree highly. Book,
it gave me the chance to think. Please, I believe her when she says her...
No.
She seems convinced, Snorri.
Very well, you...
Must you be so nicey-nicey, Frisabel? You're making me look bad.
Crystalinda, there's something I still don't understand.
Oh, that was a favor for a friend. The splendid specimen who released me from the Grimoire.
Yes, who was it? Was it Jasper?
As you know, I was trapped then. 3 months ago, he appeared.
Yeah, it's Jasper.
I will release you from your...
For a beautiful boy like you?
Wait, why is the screen glitching?
You must freeze.
Is that supposed to happen?
His name is Hendrik.
So I did as he asked. To slay a mighty beast that just happened.
The same pendant as Sir Hendrik, eh?
His name? Oh, I haven't a clue. He disappeared after he freed me, and I haven't seen him since.
Sir Jasper. The only one that has a connect... Who has a connection to Hendrik and wants him eliminated? Which actually becomes relevant.
Once again, for all you have done for me and my kingdom, the orb is yours to do with as you see.
After all, Jasper is actually a little jealous of frickin' Sir Hendrik, man. Which will become relevant during the second act, man. When we actually get Hendrik in our party. Cool, we got the final orb, man. Now we have all the Infinity Stones.
But your Majesty, isn't the orb one of your kingdom's most precious?
Of course, as my father always said.
Well, if you insist, best...
Oh, don't worry about that, little girl.
That's not very reassuring, miss. Wait, the rainbow? Right, we're supposed to take the Infinity Stones to make the Rainbow Bridge. We got all of them. Hi there. Yes. This is nice. I don't know why they put in a photo mode. They should put in a photo side quest when they remake this game again, man. Yes, they should definitely do that, like they did in Dragon Quest VIII. Well, the 3DS version of Dragon Quest VIII had that. The normal version of Dragon Quest VIII on the PS2, which I played on stream, no, it doesn't have the photo mode. And also the photo minigames that you get the cool stuff from. Yeah, but... Yeah, basically, it's exclusive to the 3DS version of Dragon Quest VIII. Which is a coincidence, because we're dressed like the protagonist of that. Look at this cool stuff that we got. Nice, huh? Pretty sweet. Right, so we need to head over to the Arborian Highlands next. Oh, I forgot we level up quite a bit. What? Huh, Quadra Bash? Oh, that's really cool. Right, so where's the Platinum Flaws? Damn, they're 1 point worse. But our Crow Claws are a +3. Which means maybe if we get a +2 or +3 on this, we'll be able... Which means if we get at least a +1, we'll be able to make it a little bit stronger. Oh hey, we can just make the Platinum Power Sword now. Damn. I feel kind of bad for wasting my time on that casino, man. No, we're not using spears. Alright, what kind of materials do we need? We need 2 platinum ore, 2 iron ore, and 1 yellow eye. Well, this should be perfectly fine. Alright, let's do our best, man. Oh, this doesn't look too hard. Alright, Sizzlypuff. This could be bad. There we go. Nope, 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 I don't want to do that. There we go. Frick, really? Right, this should be perfect. There we go. And it's all 4 in yellow. So that should make a +3. Perfect. That'll make Jade's attack even stronger. Yeah, claws are sadly very rare in this type of game. Claws are sadly pretty rare. Just like how fans were in Dragon Quest VIII. Well, I mean the 3DS version. Because you actually get a couple new party members from the PS2 version in that game. You get Red and Morty in that one. Man. I wish I could stream the 3DS, by the way, but nope. Nope, the capture cards are really expensive now and they're out of production, man. So I can't get them. Damn, that's good. Great. It'd probably turn out really well. Well, that could be... That means it's a +2. That means it's at least +2. Nowhere near to +3, though. Oh well, that'll make Rab a little bit better. Sadly, Rab's physical strength is not that good. But he does have a lot of crit chances, though. Yeah, that's a 90% critical chance, so... He'll crit at least 10 times... He'll crit at least 1 out of 10 times. Alright, so let's get Jade those new claws, man. There we go. Damn, they have an increased critical chance, huh? Damn, that's amazing. Spears are not bad, but... Spears are not bad for Jade, I actually really recommend spears for Jade as well. Ears are really, really good for her. Eric, what's up?
What are you doing?
None of your business.
We did.
Yep, we got it.
Huh? What's wrong, Will?
Oh, it's nothing, lassie. I just can't stop wondering who the handsome young fellow that...
He'd have to be very important indeed to have the same pendant as them.
I wish I...
No, it's Sir Jasper. We already know that. He was in the vision. I mean, who else would have the same pendant as him?
Come on, you horrible lot. This adventure is the over...
Sure. Well, go right away. Wait, Rab, what is that? Rab? What?
Crivens!
Rab, what is that?
Is this what you were so engrossed in back at the library, Rab? I thought you said it was a spell book.
Nope, it's porn.
Another one to add to the collection, eh? And there I was thinking you'd finally got over your little obsession.
Oh, Data's throwing shade at him.
Sir Rab, you...
And after you'd just done your rap...
Can I say that now, but whenever monsters do puff puff or try to charm you, you're gonna fall for that. Only reads them for the articles, huh? Yeah, that's everybody's excuse for them, man. Yeah, it's yes, they have very interesting... Yes, Prawn is very well known for, having a, plethora of interesting articles, man. I believe at night there's some other enemies that show up there. Yeah, some enemies will only show up at night. Lamplings, I know, only show up at night, man. I know that there's lamplings out there at night. Sir Hendrick did what he could for you guys. He beat up the bad guy. He defeated the monster. Of course, he was played just like us, man. And why do I even say at the end? There's a campsite right over here. Right, let's break camp. Supposed to show up at noon. Right. I'm not doing this to get Puff Puff, guys. I don't know what you're talking about, guys. Should focus on doing story, man. Yeah, never mind that. Never mind the freaking Puff Puff, man. We gotta We gotta do story, man. Right, where were you supposed to head? Right, does anyone remember where we're supposed to go? Right, we're supposed to go over to the Arborian Highlands. Yeah, that's the next destination in story, man. Now, the Arborian Highlands is we're getting close to the end of the first act, man. Which is a pretty good thing. That means we're about to go up against freaking... That means we're about to enter the first forest. We're about to enter the first forest and fight against Jasper, who's gonna kick our butt. Because of his plot armor. Yeah, I'm not joking, the dude literally has plot armor. Hey, there are some weird enemies I have never seen before in this area. I've never seen these guys before. Damn, they're another genie enemy. It's Lajin, a mystical genie, but different. He's like, wait now. Like, snow, yeah. Yeah, he's adapted to Arctic environments now. Actually, it looks like you're... I mean, it looks... Oh, frick, we got everybody pepped up. Damn, 25 points, huh? I'm liking those bunny... Haven't explored over here. Could be something interesting around here. Guess we'll take a look around and see what we can find. Like this treasure chest, for example. Yes, a seed of sorcery. That's gonna be useful for Veronica, mostly. Although we won't have Veronica for the second act, because she'll, Spoiler, spoiler, spoiler. Yeah, we won't have her. Wait, I've already told you that, guys. Oops. But you do get her back in the third act, man. Because of time travel stuff. Yeah. Cool. Hey. Guys, have a seat. Let's fight. Alright, let's do the hallelujah. Watch this. This is gonna make our experience crazy, man. Look at this, we're gonna win big, trust me. Yeah, this is not a chance, this is a guarantee, man. Damn, I'm wondering where Jade got this freaking giant freaking roulette wheel from. Damn, I guess Jade must be like some sort of a game show host or something. Pretty sure it's referencing casino style. Get him. Right, we didn't get our dual wield on frickin' Silvando yet. See, that knife is already doing better. Falcon knife is already doing a little bit better. And you only get a max of 3 treasures. Need a deafness and an ice crystal. And seeds of deafness are really good for Eric. Now, you're probably wondering what deafness even does, man. I must say, I was wondering the same thing, so I actually looked it up. It apparently is related to your critical chance and your ability to steal, as well as your ability to run away and... Basically, it's the luck stat, dude. Hmm. think Jade would also really like this deafness thing. And we'll stick with Eric. Let's give Eric some extra deafness. And the Seed of Lights give you like plus 5 HP. Seed of Strength give you plus 5, give you like plus 2 attack. And one island with the brownies and trolls definitely has all that. Anyway, let's go. I wonder what's different about going from here. Oh well. Sorry, that was my water bottle. You might have heard that. You can hear everything in the room. Hey, what are you? Whoa, look at that thing! Yeah, what are you? You're the guy that breaks ice, aren't you? Now that's the monster you gotta beat to get the break ice, man. First, just like with other rideable, but the only ones that are rideable are the ones that are sparkling, dude. Yeah, look at that. I knew giving Eric that extra deafness was good. We're in a completely different area, man. Ones that break ice are definitely the sparkling ones. We'll do that in a minute. First, I want to look around and see what I can find around here. Hey, there's a cow. You have milk for me. I'm not sure why these cows know stuff about weather, but I don't know. I really don't understand, but whatever. It's fine. I should probably go see these face invaders. One of these was definitely shining. Yeah, see the sparkles? That's a rideable monster. Alright, Eric, can you steal from this thing? Can you steal from the face invader? Oh, it's got a lava lamp, okay. That's actually really good because who knows what enemies have that late in the game, man. Probably in the volcano area. Pick that thing out, please. Here is fire, huh? Ouch. That was painful. Get him, Eric. Damn, 3 hits, man. That falcon knife is really coming in handy. Cool, and I like those. Damn, and our bunny tails are also coming in really handy, man. Damn, a group of enemies appeared. Get him. Platinum Power Sword, whack him! Steal from him, Eric! Damn, he failed. Yeah, we're a little hurt, so... Let's hustle, hustle! Yeah, I also found the charm item and farmed that for a little bit. Good, we got the lava lump. To get the item that increases your charm, you've got to beat those flowers that were at Puerto Valor. Yeah, where we met Silvando's dad. We're gonna charge recklessly ahead. The reason we want this thing is so we can break through ice. Like so. That's how you use this thing. What the heck are these? Slime sickles? Damn, enemies are getting weird in this game, man. Oh well, whatever. Damn, they're tough too. I expect them to have a lot of defense. News! I don't want to go to sleep. I was deflecting magic, okay? That's okay with me. Steal from Merrick? Almost. Back. News! Maybe the item will drop.
Who else wants some?
Blue Eye, of course. Oh yeah, I believe these trolls have Seas of Strength. Although it's not a guaranteed chance that we'll get it. But we pretty much can get it. Rip. The 8 bunny tails do make it possible.
Victory.
We just might get it. Tough guy tattoo. Now that's also a possibility, we can just get the common drop. Damn, what was that hitbox, dude? I was nowhere near the enemy and it said it hit me? I mean, whatever, dude! What? Get him. We gotta pay the troll toll, dude. Damn it, Eric's like, nope. Not gonna make me pay the troll toll. Hit troll. You've been trolled, you should probably just fold. So I have a question for you. Why are you guys mad, bro? I mean, it's just a game, man. Why are you mad? I'm not really sure what the point of this area is. I assume there's a treasure chest somewhere. Hey, what's over this way? Yeah, I see something sparkling up here. And I get that. I'll have to dismount to get it. There we go. That was strange. Platinum, blue eye. At least we got some platinum. The great thing about punching through enemies is you can punch through. The great thing about this is you can punch through whatever enemies you want to punch through. Oh hey, I know you. This guy's gonna become. That frozen serpent in there is gonna become a boss later on. During the second act, man. Please be expecting that, okay? I don't think there's anything else we can find over here. Let's just go to the Arborian Highlands. We got some trolls trying to make us pay the troll toll. Is there anything else around here? I don't see anything else. Charging speed! Nope, they're too slow to be... They're too slow to be defeated that easily, dude. Alright, Eric. Hit him for a lot of damage. Damn, 3 hits is pretty good, man. I should get some Seed of Strength for Jade, man. So that she can hit hard, too. Because I granted him and gave most of them to Eric, man. Damn, I'm thankful he missed that. That's a lot like the Hammerhood's attack. It can deal a lot of damage if... It can deal a lot of damage if it hits. It's like a Thunder Thrust, man. It'll always do crit. That's high damage potential. I know these trolls definitely have the strength, seed of strength, man. I know because I got them before, man. Please trust me, okay? Come on, get the troll. Let's chop our way through. Helicopter! Whack! Damn, they're sturdy. Ooh, crit! Nice job, Eric. Ooh, nice job, Jake, man. Everybody critting like crazy, man. Damn, it's running away. Get him, Eric. Damn, we still didn't get it. Oh well, the island's a much better grind place anyway. Alright, I'm going the opposite of way where we're supposed to go. This way leads to the Yorborian Highlands, right? Alright, let's break. Charging speed right ahead. We're almost at the end of the first act, guys. This is the Arborian Highlands. They're very pretty. There's also some new monsters out here. We got some new spinny dudes. Spin devils. Damn, they got the advantage on us. They might thin air us. Whirly girly! So they're grills, man. Damn, Zavondo with that crit, man. And we still haven't put Fuel Wield on him, man. Almost got him. There you go. A little bit dodgy. Right, we should definitely equip Zavondo with the second Swordbreaker. There we go. And we also got Cyclopses around here. You remember those guys from Dragon Quest VIII, don't ya? Yeah, they're in this game too. Heal from Americ. Damn. Well. Running exoskeleton, they look really... Damn. Whack him down. Get him, Zavondo. And that extra hit will definitely help him a little, too, with his offense. Yeah, plus he can dual wield swords. But why would you use swords on Zavondo? Daggers and whips are clearly some of his best. I think daggers are clearly his best weapon, though. That way he can combo well with Eric. I must say, I'm actually growing to like Zavondo. I know I said he was my least favorite character, but listen. He's turning out to be really useful, man. He's got Hustle Dance, he's got the spells. He's got Eric's dagger skills, man. Damn, they're getting two turns at once, man. Platinum War, huh? Get him, Zavondo. Damn, we're getting a lot of XP, man. Getting close to leveling up Zavondo again. Oh, we're heading the opposite way of what we're supposed to be heading. Hey look, there's those suspicious fake statues again. Let's ignore them. I don't want to fight those. Fortunately, I have to fight one of these guys. Obviously, I have to fight the one that's sparkling, of course.
Let's do this.
The reason we want to fight the one that's sparkling... It's pretty obvious, I think. Come on, hit him. I wish Jade was a little bit stronger. Definitely want to invest in Seed of Strength for her. Oh, it's ripping out gas. Damn, that hurt. Damn, these things in their 2 turns, huh? Yeah, the mechanical enemies get like 2 turns, man. Oh, Royal Rupee. Now we can ride in this. Now we can ride this thing. Nope. And we can't quite make it. But we can jump here. That janky JRPG platforming, dude. Yeah, it's just a little janky. That means it's perfect. It's like Super Dimension Neptunia. The jumping is a little janky. Yeah, I don't understand why JRPGs try to put in platforming, man. RPGs are not platformers, dude. They should stop doing that. Unless they understand both of those things. Much like, yeah, Yiz. Yiz now, that's a series that definitely will do, that does action RPG and platforming mechanics pretty well. Yeah, but they keep the platforming to a minimal in that game now. You don't have to do a lot of it. And it has a double jump, too. Now, Yiz 8 has a double jump. In Memories of Celceta, the platforming was noticeably absent, but there was swimming. And that was also that was surprisingly better than I thought it would be. It was a little jank to get used to, though. Right, we're in Arborea now. This is where Serena and Veronica are from. Of course, you already know that. They said so at the Hato Steppe, man. But they told us that Hato Steppe.
It is indeed. Welcome to Arborea, home of the Keepers. The ones who watch over the world from...
I always thought it was a little bit, well, dull.
The altar in the vision we saw appeared, but we should stop off in Arborea before we head up there.
Sure. But basically, the altar to... Basically, we're getting close to the endgame, guy. To the end of the first act. We'll be going into the second act soon.
Oh, great and glorious, the withered leaves fall from your branches, and fresh buds spring forth in their place. One life ends, and another begins.
Yeah, and they're dressed in traditional Middle Eastern gear. Only. Because this region seems like it's Greek or Roman. Definitely seems Greek to me. Maybe I'm just so used to that, man. Maybe I'm just so used to that clothing style that I don't recognize it.
Ah.
Definitely Roman time stuff.
Well, well.
Good day, Holy Father.
As do you, my dear. But, Veronica, were you not... taller when last we met?
Yeah, in any other game, this dude would definitely be a bad guy. But no.
Well, anyway, that's not important, right?
The Luminary's right there.
The Luminary.
Ah, what a blessed day this is. I am Benedictus, High Priest.
Holy Father.
Nice to meet you.
I see. So this Mordigan has corrupted the minds of Heliodor's best and boldest, and is you.
think we may know how to defeat him. There's an altar somewhere in the first forest.
It is just as I dreamed it all those months ago. It was this vision that caused me to send you on your quest to see. All is now clear. The path to the forest. I will await you there. When you have all...
Oh, we actually do have all six of the orbs, man. Yeah, this is the end of the first act. I'm sure everything will be fine and we'll get the sword that we need and we'll be able to defeat Mordigan. Yeah, that's how the game's gonna go, man. I'm absolutely sure of it. Okay, so this is on our zoom, right? Yeah, we can just zoom to Arboria. This reminds me that I haven't done the talking thin quest yet. I still have all those passwords that I haven't used yet. Next stream, I should definitely start by doing those. No, I'm fine. We're gonna end the stream here, guys. Man, we've been going on for rather long, man. Longer than I thought we would be. Anyway, thank you for watching. Remember to play games and have fun, okay? Bye-bye now. This is quite a game, huh? I love it. Well, I'll be off to grind more seeds. I'll be off to grind more strength seeds. And maybe some leaf seeds, too. Goodbye.